Hey guys, welcome back to World Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful video to any of you having a Hyundai or Kia, guys. It doesn't matter what model year it is. If you want to know the most common reason why your airbag light is on and how to reset it, guys, stay with us. We'll explain that in this video today. Before we start, let me tell you a little bit about us. Every single car we get at the garage, we try to make at least 200 to 300 free repair videos. Why we do that? Simply because our mission in the shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need, guys, in return, please subscribe to the channel, like the video. That way we can keep making these absolutely free videos for you. Now, if you guys need to buy any parts, tools to fix your Hyundai or Kia, check out the link in the description of the video below and we'll explain where you can get them from. Now, that specifically is a Hyundai Sonata, but Kia Optima is practically almost the same vehicle built on the same platform. Kia and Hyundai, they're sister companies, so for every Hyundai vehicle, there is a Kia twin vehicle as well, guys, built on the same platform. For instance, Hyundai Sonata, Kia Optima, Hyundai Accent, Kia Rio, guys, Hyundai Santa Fe, Kia Sorento, Hyundai Tucson, Kia Sportage, so forth and so on. So, now, this car, guys, okay, I have the OBD port connected. It's usually right under the steering wheel. And if you start it, you will notice that the airbag light stays on, okay? You can see. Okay, it just stays on. Okay, you can see it stays on, guys. So, what can easily cause that now? I'll recommend, guys, to get a scanner and see first, okay? It will make your life much easier. That scanner, okay, I will put the link in the description of the video below and you can see where you can get it from. Works on almost any car you can think of. It's amazing too that can pay itself off in one time use. All we have to do, click VIN number. Okay, it's going to decode it. Okay, and after it decodes it, guys, okay, it's going to tell us which vehicle that we confirm this is the correct VIN number. Ours is made for the USA market right here. Confirm that's a 2012 Sonata. And you can go to control unit, select airbag system. Here you can read the codes and tell you what's wrong with it, okay? And find out, guys. Okay, for instance, he will give you the codes and all that stuff. But number one thing, guys, will be actually that that car is completely terrible. I just need to wash my clothes every time I sit in it. It's a parts car that we have here and I want to demonstrate a few things on it. Occupant, passenger occupant system. Okay, that matter when it fails, you'll get airbag light. That's the most common one on higher mileage vehicles, guys. Number two will be, okay, the wires for the seatbelt buckles, and those are usually under the seat, guys, right here. And if you come under the seat, okay, you will see the wires underneath, okay. That's, okay, where our wires are. Let me pull them out. Okay, those yellow wires. Okay, that's it. Sometimes people will sit in the back, kick the feet under the seat, they will disconnect the wires or break them, yank them. That will disconnect the switch for the seat belts, guys, and from there it will activate the airbag light because the seat belts are actually part of the airbag system. If you're not qualified and certified to work on airbag system, seat belts, anything like that, don't do it. It's dangerous, guys, and can kill you. Also, every time you work on it, make sure you disconnect the car battery for at least 1 hour before any repairs. Don't have any open source of electricity as well. And consider this entertaining video, not a how-to video. Hopefully the video will be helpful. Thank you for watching and see you next time.